Namaste. I'm Dr. Mangalagauri Rao, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Swasthavritta and Yoga, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University. Today, I'll be discussing about the principles of nutrition and diet planning in Ayurveda. In Ayurveda, food is considered as most important thing that is responsible for the health of an individual. It is also known as Mahabhaishajya, that means the greatest medicine. In today's life, many of the non-communicable diseases are increasing day by day. The main reason behind this is diet and lifestyle. So, we need to have an intervention in the proper diet and lifestyle. Acharya Kashyapa denotes entire chapter towards the Ahara Kalpana or the different modes of preparation of the food. It has been mentioned in Charaka Samhita, Ahara Sambhavam Vastu Rogashchahara Sambhavaha Hita Hita Visheshastu Vishesho Sukha Dukhayohu. That means Ahara is responsible for the health as well as the ill health. That is, the conducive food or Hitahara will lead to the health, and the non-conducive food or wholesome food, also known by the name Ahitahara, results in different kinds of the diseases. So these will lead to the happiness and misery in a person. Before going into the details of diet, let us discuss a bit about the process of nourishment in Ayurveda. Whatever the food that is ingested, that is digested by the Agni or the Jatharagni specifically, and then it gets converted into the nourishing part, that is Sara, and the part to be expelled or also known by the name Mala or Kitta. Further, nourishing part gets absorbed and further metabolized into different body tissues called as Dhatus in the presence of Dhatvagnis. During the process, many metabolic waste are produced. They also need to be getting expelled from the body. The excellence of body Dhatu provided by the Bala and strength, also known by the immunity. This helps in promotion of health and also alleviation of the disease if one person suffers from a disease. This can be abridged in the form of the diagram, wherein here it is represented. Ahara taken, that is digested and metabolized by means of the Jatharagni, Bhutagni and Dhatvagni. Further, they move into the different srotasas or channels and reach the Dhatus and nourish them well. That will lead to the excellence of Bala and health. In the meantime, the metabolic waste are generated that need to be discarded from time to time. Further, as the channels or srotasas are key factors in the nourishment process, as well as further movement of all the dhatus or any circulation is based on the srotas or the condition of the srotas. So, the food or the medicines that are conducive to the srotas or the channels of the body are considered as pathya. It has been mentioned in Charaka Samhita, Patyam patho anapetam yadya choktam manasah priyam yachapriyam अपथ्यम च नियतम तन्न लक्षयेत. दैट इज दैट फूड और द डाइट एंड द रेजिमन एज वेल एज द मेडिसिन दैट आर कंड्यूसिव टू द माइंड एज वेल एज द बॉडी चैनल नीड टू बी कंसिडर्ड अंडर द पथ्य एंड दोज दैट आर एडवर्स टू दीज थ्री आर कंसिडर्ड एज अपथ्य. इट हैज बीन ऑल्सो मेन्शंड पथिसु स्रोतसु हितम दैट इज दैट विच इज गुड फॉर द चैनल्स इज पथ्य. फर्दर इन द चक्रपाणी टीका इट हैज बीन मेन्शंड शरीरम गृहीतम भवति ततश्च शरीरानुपघाति पथ्यमिति भवति. दैट मीन्स दैट विच इज एब्सॉर्ब्ड और एसिमिलेटेड इन टू द बॉडी एंड दैट विच इज कंड्यूसिव टू द बॉडी एंड डजंट कॉज द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बॉडी इज नोन एज पथ्य. फर्दर अगेन चक्रपाणी कोट्स दैट स्वस्थ स्वास्थ्य रक्षण आथुर व्याधि परिमोक्षश्चेति पंथाः तस्माद् अनपेतम पथ्यम मन शरीर अनुपघाति पथ्यम. दैट इज द चैनल्स हेल्प इन हेल्थ प्रमोशन एज वेल एज डिसीज प्रिवेंशन एज वेल एज क्यूर ऑफ द डिसीज एंड फर्दर दे डू नॉट हार्म द बॉडी एज वेल एज द चैनल दे आर नोन एज पथ्य. Further, in the process of nourishment, Agni is the most essential part, which is helpful in digestion, assimilation, as well as metabolism. And further, in the context of the Grahani, Acharya Charaka tells, Agni doshan manushyanam roga sanghaha prutagvida. That is, if the Agni or the factor that is responsible for digestion, assimilation and metabolism gets deranged, that will lead to the variety of diseases. So, in Ayurveda, among the principles, the concept of appetizer has been introduced to enhance the Agni, because if Agni is in the proper state, then the health of the individual will be perfect. So, Acharya Bhava Prakasha advocates a very simple remedy wherein he advocates Bhojanagre Sada Pathyam Lavanardraka Bhakshanam Agni Sandipanam Ruchyam Chikva Kantha Vishodhanam. That is, always one has to take the Ardraka or wet ginger with the rock salt or Saindhava Lavana for the enhancement of the Agni. At the same time, it brings about taste as well as clarity of the tongue, throat and the head. Further, the Agni in proper condition leads to the best state of nourishment. Further, during the cooking process, in the Ayurveda, various Ahara Upayogi Dravyas or the spices have been advocated in the form of seasoning or bhavana or processing. This will bring about the taste, flavor, as well as improve the quality of the food. Further, many of the food items that are very heavy to digest will be easily digested in the presence of spices in the proper quantity. The spices in the form of fresh ginger, garlic, turmeric, black pepper, cloves, cardamom, cinnamon, cumin seeds, coriander, nutmeg, asafoetida, ajamoda, fenugreek, etc. are frequently used in cooking. Commonly, these have the properties like Ushna Guna or hot in potency, Katu Rasa or pungent in taste, Katu Vipaka, that is after the digestion they will be pungent in their Vipaka, and commonly Kapha Vatahara and Sroto Shodhaka, that is that clarify the channels, and Ama Pachana. If there is ama or the morbid waste in the body, that also gets digested by the utilization of the spice in the form of food. And altogether, it has been always mentioned a derangement in the srotas leads to diseases. So these spices in the adequate amounts will be helpful in bringing about the clarity in the srotas that will helpful in preventing the diseases. Further, always the spices should not be used in excess. It should be used in the optimum quantity to enhance the flavor, taste, and bless the individual with a good health and longevity. Many of the researches also have been conducted on the modern parameter, wherein it has been shown that the spices will be helpful in the management of the conditions like dyslipidemia, diabetes mellitus, obesity, autoimmune diseases, neoplasms, reducing the cholesterol, blood pressure, and inhibiting the platelet aggregation, lipid peroxidation, and antioxidant natures have also been already researched. So Ayurveda have been advocating since a very long time for the usage of the spices in the optimum quantity in the food. Further, the quantity of intake of food. Matra punaragni balapekshani gurunam ardha sauhityam laghunam na triptirishyati dravo dravottarashchapi na matra guru rishyati. That is, always matra or the quantity of the food depends on the agni, whether it is optimum or it is depreciated or it is excess. Depending on that, the person should take the food. Further, gurunam ardha sauhityam, that is the heavy foods should be taken half of the stomach, and laghunam nati triptata, that is the lighter foods should not be taken in excess, and dravo dravottarashchapi, the liquids also to be consumed in the optimum quantity and should not be very heavy. So food should be consumed properly according to the agni. Further, in Charaka Samhita, it has been mentioned under the Trivida Kukshiya Adhyaya, the food should be taken to the 2/3 of one's capacity and 1/3 of the stomach should be left empty for the action of the doshas, because always the digestion of the food occurs in the presence of the agni as well as assistance of the doshas. 1/3 of the stomach should be filled with the solids, 1/3 with the liquids, and 1/3 should be left empty. And again, the water should not be taken in excess when consuming the food, because it reduces the agni that is responsible for digestion and assimilation of the ingested food. Further, the different rasas have to be taken accordingly, and again the rasas will be making the food either light or heavy because of the predominance of the Mahabhutas, that is sweet taste or madhura rasa is prithvi and jala mahabhuta, that is the earth and water principle, that is responsible for the alleviation of vata and pitta, as well as it enhances the kapha. Further, sour taste or amla rasa is predominant in fire and earth element, or agni and prithvi mahabhuta. It is having the vatahara or vata alleviating property and kapha and pitta enhancing property. Again, the salt taste or lavana rasa is predominant in water and fire elements, and it reduces the vata and increases the kapha and pitta. Katurasa or pungent taste is predominant in the air and fire elements, for vayu and agni mahabhuta, while it is alleviating kapha and vata and enhances the pitta. Tiktarasa or bitter taste is predominant in ether and air principles, or akasha and vayu mahabhuta. At the same time, it reduces pitta and kapha and enhances the vata. Kashaya rasa or astringent taste is predominant in earth and air principles, or prithvi and vata mahabhuta. At the same time, it reduces kapha and pitta and enhances the vata. Further, whenever we are taking food, at that time the different rasas need to be taken in a different order. It has been mentioned, ashniyat tanmani bhutva purvam tu madhuram rasam madhyamle lavanau paschat katu tikta kashayakam. That means, one has to take the food with full concentration. Ashniyat tanmani bhutva purvam tu madhuram rasam. That means, initially one has to consume the sweet taste. Madhye amla lavanau, that is in between the sour and salt taste, and paschat katu tikta kashayakam. In the end, one has to take the pungent, bitter and astringent taste, because physiologically, initially when a person feels hunger, at that time vata gets aggravated. So to pacify this, madhura rasa would be the ideal one. Further, as one takes the food, we need more of the digestive juices or agni, so the taste like salt and sour will be helpful in enhancing the agni or pitta. Further, in the end, the kapha dosha is enhanced due to the physiological action. So, to alleviate the kapha dosha, one has to consume pungent, bitter and astringent taste. Like this, this will be physiologically aiding the process of digestion of ingested food. Further, sometimes what happens, a person is suffering from a disease like diabetes mellitus or certain disease which is produced due to the intake of excess of madhura rasa, like obesity or cardiovascular problem or dyslipidemia. In such conditions, sweets are contraindicated. So one can take the food article that is having madhura rasa pradhanata, or that is predominant in sweet but not exactly the refined sugars or jaggery. It may be in the form of the fruits or the diet item like rice or wheat that can be used, or else it can be in the form of the sweet amla candies, or in Indian scenario they use the puddings or kheer, or in the form of rasgullas that can be had. Further, certain places the fruit juices can also be used in the form of amla juice or kokum syrup. Further, as previously mentioned, sour and salt taste stimulate the pachaka pitta that will be helpful in the digestion process, as well as they give the taste to the food. Pungent, bitter and astringent taste are also good to alleviate the kapha. And further, in Ayurveda, it has been mentioned always one has to consume the superior conducivity or pravara satmya, and that will be resulting in excellence of the nourishment of dhatus or different body tissues. So the pungent, bitter and astringent taste will bring about the balance in the different tastes that have been consumed already. Certain drinks have to be consumed from time to time. For example, it has been mentioned in the Ayurveda, bhojanante pibet takram, vasarante pibet payah, nishante pibet dwari, tribhi rogo na jayati. That is, one has to take buttermilk or takra at the end of the meals and milk at the night time or at the end of the day, and water in the morning or at the end of the night. Whenever the food is being consumed, different factors need to be kept in mind. It has been mentioned in Charaka Samhita, Matra Kala Kriya Bhumi Deha Dosha Gunantaram Prapya Tattadhi Gashyante Te Te Bhavastata Tatha. That is, the quantities are dependent on the dosage or the matra kala, that is in the form of seasons or the time of day or night, or whether the person is young or middle-aged or the old age, and further the method of preparation, as well as the place where one stays and the different combinations of the food. Sometimes it may be good or sometimes harmful for the body.